Dear students, welcome to another subtopic which based on geomorphological or on the diastrophism, whereby the earth can be moving from one place to another. But this subtopic is called vulcanistic. According to this description, this refers to the eruption of molten materials within the earth's crust are either extruded on the earth's surface or intruded within the earth's crust. Dear students, there is a certain terminology here you have to understand yourself. Intruded or intrusive. Intrusive. Okay, another, there is extrusive. Okay. Injection. Internal. Here there is ejection and extrusive. These are relevant in each other. Intrusive, injection, or internal, this is the situation of material to be within this crust, within or inside. But this is outside. External, injection, extrusive. This is the way the material can come on the surface. Therefore, this eruption is eruption. Whenever we talk about eruption, this is when material is just moving from within the earth crust and they come on the earth surface or remain within the earth crust, but it can be originating from its source or to the formation. Okay, or intruded within the earth crust. Therefore, because you are talking about vulcanism as the eruption of molten, and you have to remind yourself the meaning of molten. Molten, these are material which are liquid forms. Liquid form. Are the porridge. But whenever we be moving or erupting from within or from its origination, it can be cooling this liquid material which are hot in nature. Why is not is hot in nature? It's hot because it have been heated with a certain mineralization which are radioactive elements. For instance, sodium, radon, uranium, and other material of the same nature. But wherever these molten materials will be coming on the air surface, that is called vulcanistic. But it's called vulcanistic. Therefore, there is a difference terminology here, vulcanistic and vulcanistic. Vulcanistic, this is the process of either intrusive or extrusive. But whatever will be coming on the surface as the extrusive one is called the vulcanistic. I think I will describe more in the next. Okay, cause of vulcanistic, all reason. First, the presence of radioactive. In order for the formation of this vulcanistic or eruption of molten material, the following reason it should be taking place. Firstly, the presence of radioactive elements. Not only that, but also a tectonic activities or movement of the earth crust. Well, let's start with this eruption or presence of radioactive. Dear students, this radioactive elements, these are the ones which are radicate in nature or which can be erupting easily because these are not stable in nature. Therefore, this element is the one which can heat the material which are liquid in nature, are the molten ones or are the liquid ones. Therefore, wherever will be heated can be forced to move, or due to the presence of pressure, can be forced to come on the air surface. And wherever the pressure or the forcement will be low in nature, can remain within the air crust. And it's just passing to the area of weakness. For instance, crack, which can be vent in nature, or can be fissure in nature. Vent is a large crack, but wherever the crack will be small in nature is called the fissure. Okay, volcanism can result into the intrusive features which material cool and solidify or can change from liquid into the solid states. satisfied within the S-class. And S-O excludes features when materials cool and satisfy on the surface, as I told you. Exclusive is likely, I told you that material which come on the surface is called exclusive, or ejection, or exclusive, or external features. Therefore, and according to the on the surface, or rubber, when the materials are ejected outside, they come or can pass through the vent, which is large fracture or crack, to form a volcanoes, or through a fissure or small fracture to form a rubber. Plateau or exclusive volcanicity is also called volcanicity. Therefore, the material which, because material is molten nature, but this molten material, wherever will be remain within the S-class, move and remain within the S-class before to reach to outside or on the surface, this material is called magma. But wherever this molten material will be erupting and pass through to the area of weak process, fissure or vent, and come on the air surface, this material will be changed from molten to lava. Lava will be called lava because it have been solidified from liquid into the solid. Okay, but you have to remind yourself that all exclusive volcanists, there is a volcanist and the volcanist. These two words you have to remind yourself. This volcanicity, this is the process of molten materials, either intruded or extruded. Intruded, this is the situation of eruption of molten material and remain within the crust. But whatever will be coming on the surface, passing through to the area of weakness, therefore, even this material, it can be called volcanicity. And whatever this volcanicity will be erupted and come on the surface, will be changed from molten into the lava. But wherever this material will be remaining in the crust will be called magma. Okay. Intrusive features of volcanism. Wherever the eruption of molten material will be taking place and cause for the formation of different features within the crust, therefore, can lead for different features to be taking place. For instance, dike, seary, lacrolithy, facrolithy, and the batholithy. Therefore, we have to describe more so as to understand and to be farmers or to avoid the claiming capacity. You have to know or to understand. Dear students, let's start with the first feature, which is called the dike. Before to go to description of dike, see the lacrolithy, batholithy, and facrolithy or batholithy, therefore, there are some features which can be taking place on the surface. These exclusive volcanistic features, all volcanistic features are volcanoes, crater, lava, plateau, and caldera. I think we will describe more wherever you proceed to observe Mr. Sajo or Mwalimu Mayala. You have to remind yourself that this material which are ejected through the volcanicity can be either acidic or basic in nature. As I told you that the landmass which you are just walking on it, this is consists of acidic in nature, acidic, or base, or alkante, basic in nature. And this acidic or base are different in terms of capability. Because some acids are weak in nature, or strong in nature. But even these basic are weak and the others are strong. Therefore, even the process of eruption or eruption of molten material, it can be different in terms of taking place on the surface or within the crust. Therefore, you have to remind yourself that material is which are ejected or come on the surface through the volcanism can be either acidic or basic. Let's start to know the material which are acidic in nature. First, this material which are acidic are very viscous. Dear students, viscous, this is the eruption of molten materials in terms of high speed or high pressure or forcement. Why? Because the material have more powerful to arise some material and come on the surface to high speed and cause for the formation of a certain features which and these features, it can be different in terms of size and in terms of shape. Not only that, rapid rate. The formation or eruption of material which are acidic in nature, it can be erupting in terms of rapid. Rapid, this is a continuous at high speed. Therefore, material which are acidic in nature, it can be prolonging to erupting, erupting from within this crust and just passing from to the area of weakness. For instance, the area of weakness is just flowing from this area, pass through, and wherever will be remaining within can cause for the formation of different features. But wherever will be forced, or wherever the pressure will be high in nature, can force this material to come on the surface and cause for different features, which we will observe later. Dear students, can form steep slope. Steep slope, this is the part of slope, which, and the slope, it can be with different categories or types, which can be gentle in nature, gentle in nature, steep in nature, concave, convex in nature, concave in nature. But the most one, these two are the most of slope, which are gentle and steep. Dear students, here according to acidic, the material which is just erupting are forming the steep slope. Why just forming steep slope? Because the eruption is rapid in nature. It's just forced and rise forces. Material is just flowing from within the crust and pause to come in terms of steep slope. This is steep slope because the formation of this slope, wherever you put water here and to allow flowing, the water will be moving rapidly or quickly as possible because the slope of this landmass or this this landscape or landform are steep in nature. That's why even the material which is just erupted with the acidic are forming the steep slope. Not only that, it contains more silica. These are material which consists of some element which are silicon in nature. Apart from that, material which are basic in nature, it can be with the following characteristics or features. First, form a gentle slope. Dear students, because this material which are basic in nature have low viscous, and the viscous is the one which can cause for the formation or forcement to be high or low. But this material which are basic in nature, they can cause for the formation of gentle. Gentle is when the landmass is not forced to go high, because the one which are acidic, they form steep slope because the forcement is just forming at the conical shape because the forcement is high. But this of base is just forced upwards. For instance, this is a landmass and cause for gentle. Therefore, this slope of A are the gentle slope, and this for B, which are steep, are different in terms of appearance or of acidic. Dear students, you have to remind yourself, even myself, I'm the among of Tanzania who have been climbed the Mount Kilimanjaro. And you have to remind yourself that Mount Kilimanjaro consists of two ranges. There is Mount Mawenzi and Kibo. But most of Mount Kibo is the one which is just climbing. Most of the people is just climbing Mount Kibo. Why is Mount Kibo? Because it is gentle in nature. That's why the people is just passing through. And because the Mount Kilimanjaro consists of two ranges, therefore, the one which is Mawenzi is high or conical shape. Why is conical shape in nature? Because maybe the material which have been forced or erupted this material at the mountain to and come on the surface cause for the lava, maybe was acidic in nature. But the Kibo is the one which forced with basic nature. Why is basic? Because the base is not viscous in nature. Therefore, even the formation of this landmass in terms of shape and size will be in terms of gentle. But Mount Kilimanjaro in terms of Mawenzi ranges, because of acidic, even the eruption was so viscous. At the middle, all the landmass which separating or connecting to mountainous, this is called the saddle. For those who have been the saddle, for those who have been climbed this mountainous, there is a place or the plain area which joined two mountainous, which is called the saddle. Na mimi nimepanda na kuna kibao kimeandikwa saddle. Unapita kutoka from Malangu Way or Malangu Gateway. Therefore, you can pass at different stages, but this Mount Mawenzi is impossible to climb because it is highest. Some of them is just climbing, but most of them is just climbing to this cable, and at the top there is snow due to the concept of lapsate, which states that wherever you are just increasing the heat, the temperature will be decreasing.